Over the next 10 days, I'm doing a simple one tip a day video. Check back tomorrow for another. Today, I thought I'd try something different, like as in something I have no idea how to do, but I saw someone else do on Reddit and I thought, that looks cool and easy, let's do a quick episode on it. It's a good job I'm planning these 10 videos ahead and making them before I release them, that's all I can say to that, because 2 days later, I'm finally getting around to actually reporting on my results. Let's do it. So it turns out putting a texture on something is hard. I already kinda knew that from way back when I used to mess about with 3D Studio Max, if you're old enough to remember. Do they still do that? I don't know. But anyway, yeah, that was early 2000s. The making of a 3D model is way easier than making a convincing texture. And this is probably why when you look at old games from around that time, you have hilariously unconvincing textures in them too, I guess. It's very easy to end up in Uncanny Valley, as they call it, especially with wood, because wood is hard to fake. I started out trying to follow this tutorial, but I'll be honest with you, I'll link it below, but unless you're competent at Blender, and I'm the exact opposite, I literally just installed it and it's mind-bogglingly complex, and I don't just mean hard to learn, it is a huge thing with way too many options, and I have to wonder, does anyone know how all this works? Is it even possible to know how all this works? Anyway, I failed abysmally, so I tried another tutorial, which I will link below, it's also from another Reddit link. I had limited success with this one, and this is a really good tutorial, so props to this guy, but I still had limited success, and the problem is that with complicated software that you just don't know how to use, is that even the slightest change in the interface, how the menus work, or anything that's wrong with your model, or anything like that, and you're just suddenly out of your depth straight away if you can't figure out what's going on. I think the main issue with texturing 3D models for 3D printing is that you're not strictly texturing them in a way that you would for an image. You're actually displacementing the surface rather than applying an image to it, if you get what I mean. That's what Blender calls it, displacement map, I think it is. I know you kind of do both if you do serious rendering, but the point I'm making here is that a nice image texture that you find on the internet is not necessarily, or generally not in my experience, which isn't much experience, it's not going to give you the right results when you're using it as what is essentially a depth map. And I can't really find any good examples of those either. It must be a thing, but I'm lost. Anyway, this is the best we ended up with. Hardly inspiring. And I've also noticed that many textures that you might otherwise be happy with, they just end up looking like printer faults. I mean, it seems ironic to spend hours solving a banding issue or a ghosting issue and then try again to do it on purpose. But oh well. And of course, it's probably compounded by the fact that I entered all this without actually having any wood filament. I don't use wood filament, I don't really like the idea of it, to be honest, but let's move on. Even though these are supposed to be short videos, I didn't feel like this was a good place to stop the video, so I poked around a bit and I found out that you can do some so-called texturing in Mesh Mixer using the Sculpt menu, which comes as part of Fusion 360 in case you didn't already know that. Results were disturbing, if I'm honest, you might want to look away. This function is actually really useful if you want to make asteroids or moons, but for anything else, I'm kind of out of my league here as well. But anyway, this isn't just a video of me telling you all the things that I tried to do and failed. I mean, it kind of has been up until now, but there is a real option for us normal people who don't have qualifications in 3D graphics. Depending on what you watch, you may or may not have seen or heard of ideamaker, and I feel like I'm being almost insultingly brief at this point, but I want to keep the video short. I have to cover this in more detail in future, because from the short time that I've used this slicer, yes, it is a hole slicer, and it even supports Octoprint. I actually really liked it from using it. You can add textures to an STL in ideamaker so easily that you don't really need me to tell you how. There's literally a texture button here. Options are a lot more limited than Blender, but really it's a quick and easy method for most things, and it will do the trick. And the best bit is that there's an online texture library that you can easily browse and pull things in from. And it's worth noting that ideamaker is actually free as well, just like Cura and Prusa Slicer. In the end, I still didn't get any kind of wood texture that I wanted. These results were a bit weird, but honestly I kind of gave up and started doing some other things which look cooler. I mean, who wants wood anyway? So that is where I'm going to stop today. As I said, I will cover this slicer, hopefully soon and properly, with a full week or so of research and planning as usual, because I think it deserves more attention. But honestly, if you have the time to check it out anyway at this point, then just do so, because it's really simple to use. I will link you below how to get hold of it. As for future videos on Blender, well, don't look at me. I'll link you below to one by Casey Farris, who is a great teacher. I've learned a lot about Da Vinci Resolve from that guy. Otherwise, I will see you tomorrow.